the Packers and their fans will have a great week. Yeah. Listen, neither one of us thought that Aaron Rodgers was going to sit out the season. I left the door ajar, and it looks like I'm going to be off on this based on the Ian Rappaport report that he will report to camp tomorrow and be ready to roll in day one. I thought there was a decent chance that Rodgers, you know, just the way he's wired, maybe a little spiteish, if you will, skip a couple of days, just send one more little jab, one more little message, and then come and get ready to ball. But it looks like he's showing up on time.
Yeah, it looks like he's going to be there on time. The only other thing that was vaguely possible, BT, was that he would retire. And retire because he's going through this life transition. You know, we all know he's getting married. He's been on vacations and you know, engagement, all that thing. Like he really took me time, as he talked about, and worked on himself. And so upon reflection, after 38-year season, you know, his third MVP, getting to the NFC Championship game, it would have been, you could have seen him saying, I don't really want to do this anymore.
Yep.
I don't love the situation I'm in. I want a different stage in my life. Jeopardy's going to hire me full-time to be the host, so I'm going to have fulfillment and something professionally to do. I'm bouncing. I'm out of this thing. That was a possibility, but I still feel like he loves it. And physically, he's not shot. You know what I mean? He
doesn't not even look close.
He doesn't look like Peyton Manning at the end, who we wanted to see Peyton keep playing, but after a while, we were like,
yeah, it was getting ugly,
man,
at the end there.
You can't even throw the ball 30 yards, man. So exactly. Aaron Rodgers is nowhere near that.
Nope.
And so I knew that he was going to eventually show up if he didn't retire. And on time makes it so there's no controversy. The only controversy is how long it's going to last as him and his compatriot, Devontae Adams, are posting cryptic social media messages.
Which I'm not a fan of, which we'll tell you what they said in a moment for sure. And using the controversy angle, I do think I want to bring something into the equation in a moment about, you know, how this could play out in real time. Obviously, he's coming back. And I want to read this as well from Ian Rappaport. Talk about having the scoop of the year. Mm-hmm. I mean, everybody was chasing this. And, you know, others have, you know, have weighed in and said, yeah, sources. But Rappaport was the one who had this first. And he tweeted earlier today, Aaron Rodgers has indicated to people close to him that he does plan to play quarterback for Green Bay this season. Sources say this is the expectation. Many factors are at play. But with GM Brian Gutekunst saying, quote, he is hopeful for a positive outcome. There's a glimmer of optimism. All right, the more the glimmer. Aaron Rodgers shows up, you got a chance to win. Aaron Rodgers doesn't show up, you're going, you know, you 7 or 8 wins if you're lucky with Jordan Love, not ready to be a star yet.
You're scrambling.
You're scrambling. You are definitely scrambling. Here's what I think. Now, they're going to be one of the favorites to win it, as they should. We can get to the little tweet fest and Instagram fest in a moment, but what's going to be interesting, again, the way he's wired, that you have to incorporate this, that first little outward miscommunication with LaFleur, and I know he's a fan of LaFleur, and LaFleur obviously loves him, but that's going to be played up on the sidelines, the first bad loss, just because it looks as if Rodgers is showing up and getting ready to strap on the helmet and play some football, doesn't mean this year is going to be without drama.
No.
It'll be a lot of it.
Well, no matter what happens, it's going to be the undercurrent of this entire season. Even if they win a championship, it's still going to be part of the storyline. There's no way that we're going into this 2021 season and say they get deep into the postseason in the 2022, even get to the Super Bowl, and this little piece of offseason is not part of the story, whether it was galvanizing and lifting in some regard.
True.
Or whether it was divisive and they fall apart and end up, you know, being 7-10. You know what I mean?
Yeah, 7-8. Finally got it. There you go.
A little practice
now.
I had to think about it.
Training camps have opened. You've got to know there's 17 games.
Exactly. 7-10. If they're that, this is what we're pointing to.
Uh-huh.
So this part of the story isn't going away, even if Aaron Rodgers shows up and everything is fine and him and Devontae Adams are cryptic about their futures, which we know is now a reality because there are talks, Devontae Adams talks for a contract extension as one of the best wide receivers, not the best wide receiver in the NFL, are done.
Yeah, they're not paying him.
Of course.
They're not paying
him. And if he doesn't want to be there, and you know he's talking to Aaron, that means that Aaron's only there for a short amount of time longer.
Oh, there's no question. And it also means I think the Raiders are in play here with Devontae Adams. You know, Derek Carr was waxing poetic about his former college teammate.
You think they're going as a package team?
Rodgers and Adams to the Raiders? I hope at this point I have no. Let's just cross this bridge first.
Yeah, okay.
Let's get a microphone in Aaron Rodgers' face tomorrow when he shows up.
Yep.
I mean, I can't wait to hear what he said, but we do know what was said. Let's flash it back here. This was late April. GM Brian Gutekunst on whether or not Rodgers will play for the Packers again. This is a couple of months months ago, so all the speculatory stuff is seemingly in the rearview mirror. A couple things to sift through here. First of all, let me read you a tweet, all right? A tweet. This one from Michael Silver.
We like Mike.
Yeah, we know Mike. We like Mike. About 3 hours ago. And Michael tweeted, one possible solution to the Rodgers-Packers stalemate, the team could agree to lop off the final 2 years of his contract, just get rid of it, and theoretically not to franchise him after the season to set up kind of a last dance scenario. Again, this is Michael Silver communicating this. Not likely, but maybe the Packers decide 1 year is better than none. Okay, pretty smart, sensible take there. I'm sure he's got his
sources.
His sources, obviously. But this is interesting. Then they both posted an Instagram story, which anybody who's on Instagram knows it eventually dissolves and it's gone. So Adams is now gone. I believe Rodgers is still up there, meaning Adams put his on earlier, I believe. Yeah, Rodgers still up there. And it's the same exact picture of Jordan Pippen, you know, dapping up basically, insinuating a last dance scenario.
Yeah. I mean, all we can do is speculate. Aaron Rodgers isn't someone to try to make jokes on social media. So I believe he's following what Devontae Adams and him are actually talking about, and that we're going to give this one last shot. And you know what? If they're getting one last shot and what Mike Silver is speculating about, which he could be true, I think that's a win-win. It's a decent compromise for all parties.
Yes.
Because, as you mentioned going into the last break, BT, the Packers are not ready to win with Jordan Love, right?
No.
From what we heard, and because we have not seen him, so it's really hard to judge him and what his NFL career is going to be like. We haven't seen it with our own two eyes. We know what he did in college at Utah State. We don't know what he's going to be in the NFL. For us to sit here and say, oh, they're not going to miss a beat with Jordan Love at quarterback would be disingenuous and naive, right? So the only way that this Packers team, who has been in two straight NFC championship games, can try to get back again and win one last time is with Aaron Rodgers and Devontae Adams being okay with the circumstance they find themselves in.
And the other thing it does, it bakes in some more time to really get a proper evaluation on Love.
Agreed.
Because you know
that's
this,
important.
It's imperative.
Yeah.
I mean, it's beyond important. It's a must. I mean, think about this entire offseason, all the organized team activities, where you have to go, where you don't have to go. I mean, Jordan Love has lived in that building. Because as you and I discussed many times, even though we both thought that Rodgers would come back and play, and it looks like we'll be right, you still have to prepare, and coaches need to communicate to Love, hey, listen, we don't know what's going on, so you better be ready to take that first snap on week one and in week one, just in case Aaron Rodgers doesn't show up. So now they've got a sense of his diligence, his ability to, you know, consume something, spit it back quickly. They haven't yet seen him process things on the field because you're not going to hit each other, obviously, and that's when things are going quickly. But now, one more year gives them a real chance to win a Super Bowl, and now they will definitively know, did we draft a project who was almost ready, or did we draft a project and whiff?
Yeah, that's right. And they're going to know it sooner rather than later, which is, I guess, okay. But I have to look at this from Aaron's standpoint. Like, what does Aaron ultimately want to do with his life? I think that, you know, I didn't realize this until I was watching something earlier today. I forget what show. Maybe it's on ESPN, breaking down Aaron Rodgers' career.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't realize, and I mean, I know the last two, but I didn't realize he's been in four NFC championship games and not advanced. So he's been there four times and not advanced. And I'm not knocking him at all, obviously, because he's a three-time MVP. He's one of the best quarterbacks in the league. But he could easily have been keeping pace with Tom Brady over the years, right? But he's fallen short. And so if you're Aaron Rodgers, you loathe this front office situation in Green Bay. You still got, you know, gas left in the tank, and you've been playing your entire career in Green Bay where, you know, just like Tom said, the weather sucks in the winter, right? It's, you know, the championship parade, even Tom Brady was talking about how you couldn't enjoy it in New England because it was 20 degrees outside.
Makes sense.
Whereas in Tampa, you're on a boat, you're tossing the trophy back and forth. I can easily see Aaron Rodgers giving it his all. He will never short the Packers, ever.
Agreed.
He'll never, you know, lay down his sword and say, yeah, well, whatever, this is just a toss-off season, nobody cares.
No.
He'll make one last run at this and then go someplace south or someplace else, California, who knows, Las Vegas with the Raiders, and give it one or two more shots, maybe even three more shots, because he's still young relative to quarterbacks being able to play. If you look at Tom Brady now going on 45. So this actually sets up the perfect, like, exit, because this was getting ugly, right? This felt like it was going to be vicious, this ending. And now it kind of maybe feels a little bit less so.
It's thawed a bit. That's a tough word to thawed.
Thawed, yeah.
Never really comes out smooth. Thawed. Very aggressive start.
It's because there's hard contents all over.
Thawed. No, seemingly thawed here. And listen, the other thing, I know that the Raiders are, you know, always going to be in play because nobody really knows exactly how they feel about Derek Carr, despite Coach Gruden constantly waxing poetic about his talents. And, you know, Mayock, to a lesser extent, kind of doing the same thing. We think they love him, but you don't really know. The Vikings situation can change, though I don't see him necessarily going to Minnesota.
No.
You know, you think that Garoppolo's going to be a goner after this year, but you just drafted Trey Lance. Maybe they do. Maybe Trey Lance sits for, who knows. But the other thing that now happens is there will be other situations that will open up that right now we're not thinking about. Now, you and I both like Daniel Jones.
Mm-hmm.
We both think the Giants could be really good this year. At the very least, very interesting in a competitive, if not great, NFC East. But if Daniel Jones bombs, again, we don't think he will, but if he does, that opens up maybe New York. I don't know if Aaron Rodgers would want that.
Or even Philly with Jalen Hurts.
That just seems like too much more of a different kind of a rebuild.
Mm-hmm.
I think, we'll get to this later, Deshaun Watson. I think, first of all, Deshaun Watson's getting dealt in the next 2 weeks. I think it's happening. It's imminent.
Yeah.
And I don't think it's going to be Denver. I think it's going to be Miami.